writer, Smita Vishwanath. Smita Vishwanath got published in Meticulous Men of Metal for the first time, and that time she had come all the way from Dubai to India to write for the publishing house.
She never fails to say that.
Okay, and actually, yes, it's such immense pleasure it gives you when you see people, those who are so good, so kind, so passionate, so polite, and so expressive, and they are a part of your team. So welcome,
Smita. Thank you so much, Meena. I'm really excited to be part of these two books, Broken Bits of the Moon. When I saw the picture, actually, when Mr. Najib Sir actually sent the picture, I just knew I had to write for that book. And especially a little paragraph that
blurb.
He had mentioned. The blurb that
beautiful
he had mentioned.
Beautiful blurb has been written by Najib Sir.
And I knew I had to be a part of this book. I've written a story titled Chandrakala. It's apt. It's my mother's name. And it means moonbeam. So the story kind of revolves around family. I mean, you need to read it. Okay, and let me know your view. But I've dedicated it to her. Speak Your Mind, I've written three articles. One on senior citizens, old age homes for senior citizens. In India, we're very particular about educating our children. And we say girls and boys equally need to be educated. We want our children to have the best education. And my parents wanted it too. And we're extremely proud when our children do well, get jobs abroad and go. And yet, we're a hypocritical society. Because when the parents grow old and you say, I'm looking for an old age home for my parents, how can I come back? And eyebrows just shoot up. Because, and they're judging you again. They're judging you. I mean, you should be here taking care of your parents. But you really can't have your feet in both the boats. I mean, it's either you let your children, you educate your children and let them go.
Set them free.
And I'm not saying this because I'm a child. I'm saying it also because I'm a mother and I will follow the same rule for my children.
Sure.
Yeah? But India does not have too many of these facilities. There's really nothing wrong in putting your parents in old age home where they will be in good old age home, senior citizens home, where they will have, they can mingle with people of their own age group. Everything will be taken care of. It doesn't mean you love your children, your parents any lesser. It just means that everybody's living in their space.
So is it about the children, those who go abroad and they can't take care of
yes,
their parents?
It's either abroad or even here. I mean, if you're posted into another city and your parents don't want to leave the city in which they are in, it just becomes difficult and it's really stressful for both the parents as well as the children. So my first topic was on more old age homes, because like in the US, they don't ever have to worry about where they're going to go, because you know, out of the tax money, it's taken care of, and nobody says, oh my god, he's staying in an old age home or she's staying in an old age home. It's accepted and it's pretty respectable. The second thing that I've written about is about public defecation toilets. This topic actually, it was the last topic I actually wrote about, because I was speaking to my husband and he said, you must write about it. And I'm like, why? I haven't really seen public defecation happening anymore. You know, earlier when I used to land in Mumbai, it used to be landmark. Or yeah, when you see the, you know, see someone with that aluminium container sitting, squatting there, then you know you've reached Mumbai. But now I didn't see it. But you still have this problem, you know, if you're working in any of the buildings near the airport from the top, all you get to see is this view. And while as part of the Swachh Bharat campaign, public defecation has reduced from 69% to 35%. That is from, I think, this is 2015, as per the 2015 data. It's still a huge problem. And it's not about building toilets. It's also about people being advised to use them. So there are two things. It's toilets are being built, but you know, you need to train them because they feel happier squatting in open air. It's cleaner, it's fresher and less stinkier. So that's the second topic that I've written about. And the third topic that I've written is about suicide. Actually, I'd written a poem on World Suicide Prevention Day. And when I posted that poem on my blog, someone, I don't know who that person is, but prone to suicide actually commented on my poem. They were looking for something more. When I tagged suicide and suicide prevention, they weren't looking for a poem. They wanted meat in it. Okay, and there was nothing except a poem. So they actually told me, you know, you tagged suicide, what is there in this for us? You have no clue what a person goes through when they are depressed. And then I promised that person, I said, you know, on the blog, I said, I will make it up to you. And then this topic came, the speak your mind, and I said, let me just write. Mm-hmm. So even in my topic, I have written verbatim that person's comments and mine. And so this is dedicated.
Okay.
Really nice.
Three topics. Really nice. Very good. Thank you so much.
Thank you.